Yo lads, how's it going? And welcome back to another YouTube video. I'm not gonna lie, I'm starting to get a little bit consistent on this platform. It feels a little bit weird. If you guys are OG, then you'll know that me uploading onto YouTube was never really a consistent thing. So, you know, I'm getting there. But anyway, today we have the brand new four-season spring event. It's kind of the replacement for La Liga rivalries, Bundesliga rivalries, and Easter. They're kind of all merged into one. The only real bad thing is that we don't have the golden egg hunt that we've had for 4 years on the row now. This is the first year we've never had that. So that kind of does suck. But this event is kind of... It's a little bit confusing, but it's not too bad. And the rewards that you get from it are pretty nice. Just a reminder for you guys that I do also have a Twitch channel. I tend to stream on there about 3-4 times a week. So if you're not already following me on Twitch, there's a link on screen. There's also a link in the description. And if you want to keep up to date on more socials like Twitter and Discord and all that good stuff, there's more links in the description for them. But my guide videos have really been popping off. So if you do enjoy the video, please do leave a like, subscribe if you are new to the channel. If you are the type of viewer that follows me all across other platforms, I really do appreciate the support. Some of the numbers that I'm getting recently are damn crazy. So let's keep getting there. We're aiming for 10k subs by the end of the year, so make sure you're subbed if you're new. But into the event. Four season spring event. It's a nice little event, I can't lie. It's a little bit simple, but the rewards that you get from it are pretty epic. The only thing that I wish was changed from this promo was instead of like 5 still games and then 2 AR games at the end, I know I'd like it to be like 2 versus games with some of the Easter players, 3 skill games, 2 AI games, and then you get the nice wide range of it. The way that it was ran in Luna, I kind of enjoyed. Personal preference. But for you guys that want to log in and then just do a couple of minutes a day and then the event's done, this is a good event for you guys. Just note there's some extra milestone rewards in here as well. But the basic event flow comes from doing the 5 daily skill games and then the 2 event games at the end. From daily logins and completing the daily skill games and completing the daily versus attack matches, you get yourself a guaranteed 25 watering cans a day. You get the 15 from the end of the path. You get the 5 for the 2 versus attack or head-to-head wins. And then you get 5 for logging in to make the 25. These 25 watering cans are used in the matchup melons, the slide tackle strawberries, and the goalpost grapes section. These help you give gifts. If you guys were around for the football freeze event, basically it's instead of gold, elite, and master gifts, it's now melon, strawberries, and grapes. That is the only difference. The color scheme is still the same. So it's easier to get the gold gifts. It's harder to get the elite gifts, and then the master gifts are a lot more harder. In terms of the leaks, what comes out for the gifts, that'll be later on in the video. But basically, when you end up doing some of the gifts, you'll get yourself some bonus points at the end. The bonus points are used in the cream of the crop section. That just gives you some extra resources, maybe some extra points, and all that good stuff. The egg hunt is basically the usual player wheel. However, we're getting about 5 resets on this. These reset every 5 days. So I think on the last day, the players are only going to be out for 1 day. And then the neighborhood section is the main part of this event. Basically, from doing the rain or shine section, from completing all the games, you end up getting a total of 505 neighborhood points every single day. I'll put up the math on screen now. So in terms of the stamina calculations, you start out with 21 stamina. You get 24 stamina refills. And because the event is 3 weeks long, then you get the 24 times the 21. The 21 times 21 comes from the daily ads. You get 7 each ads. You get 3 a day. 21 times 21. And then the 147 comes from the 7 lots of coin packs. And they come over the course of 3 weeks. That gives you a total of 1,113 stamina. Just note that you can only complete this path once. Therefore, to do all 7 of the skill games and the AI matches, you need 49 energy a day. Times that by the 21 gives you the 1,000 stamina that you need. So you don't need to open the coin packs. It's just there if your stamina ends up refilling for the next day. So over the course of the event, you get 10,605 neighborhood points. That doesn't include what you get from the garden gifts. Once you've planted the seeds to end up growing your melons or your strawberries or your grapes, use them in here. And as the guide said from EA's original guide tweet, gifts change every 24 hours, so you must plan your harvest times approximately. Melon points open melon gifts, strawberry points open strawberry gifts, grape points open grape gifts. Bonus points are the cream of the crop gifts. But the possible rewards that you can get from the gifts include resources, common and rare shards, base players, spring break players, egg hunt tokens, neighborhood points, icon points, and team of the week or premium points. Just the same as it was for freeze. If you guys want to get yourself a boost on getting like the prime icon Kaka, Hierro, or Owen, then you might want to look at the icon points. If you guys want to save yourself a couple of gems to end up getting the Messi from the neighborhood chapter, then you might want to get the neighborhood points where applicable. Right, now what's the best path on the neighborhood section? On the first one, you end up getting some sunshine points. The sunshine points are used to unlock the strawberries and the goalpost grapes, which end up giving you your gold, elite, and master gifts in the end. So that's what that currency's for. The rest of the nodes, you end up getting some neighborhood players, which is basically the player wheel, so where you get the Castillos, the Vidal, etc. And then in the rest of the nodes, you can get yourself some resource rewards like coins, skill boost, training XP, all that jazz. All right, so now what is free to play? As you remember from earlier, I said that you can get 10,605 neighborhood points from free just by doing the seven daily skill games and AI games. And the 10,000 points allows you to go straight down the middle to unlock yourself an End of Era Bender. You get to choose one of them, so you got to be careful which one you choose. In my opinion, if you want the best card, then you go for the centre-back. If you want to go for something that helps your team, we've had a lack of right-backs this year, so this Bender might be your option. He doesn't look that good, though, but the better player is definitely the centre-back one. His stats actually come on par with Ultimate Team of the Year Virgil van Dijk when 20 to 100 with a plus 13 skill boost. This card actually doesn't look terrible. So if you go straight down the middle and you're not spending any gems or whatsoever, this is the best route that you can do. The bottom middle on node 9, that'll unlock the lower left one and the lower right. Then what you do, you go to the end, get the 99 player and then claim him. And then on the other side, you can also claim both 99s. So going from the start is 100 plus 140 plus 195 plus 275 plus 375 plus 550 plus 755 plus 1200 plus 1330. That's 4,900 points to get to the bottom node 9. That claims yourself either at the End of Era Benders. And then if we add 4,920 to 150 plus 195 plus 255 plus 330 plus 430 plus 1,000, that's 7,280 points, which still means you have approximately 3,000 points left over. So 1,280 plus 150 plus 195 plus 255 plus 330 plus 430 plus 1,000 is 9,640 points, which means you still have about 900 points left over still, which you can use to claim some egg hunt tokens if you want them. Or with the extra 900 points that you have left over, you can claim yourself either of the other 95, so Lenglet or Isco. If you want to go for the Messi, then note on this node, you need to complete lower left 11 and lower left 6 in order to unlock it, which means you have to unlock this one and this one. So here's the math back on screen. So 10,605 neighborhood points over the course of the event. And then the next section shows you how many watering cans you can get. But in order to do every node to get Messi, you need to go straight down in the first path. Then you need to go across to the left. And then you need to go back up to the neighborhood bit. Then go left. And then go down. Then you go to the left to claim Messi. In total, that is 14,550 points. Which means if you're purely doing it from the neighborhood gem pack, you need to spend 20,000 gems. And then it's an extra 2,500 gems in order to get the Riquelme. Doing all this Rivaldo stuff is a lot of gems. I'm not going to go into that. Yeah, you don't deserve that much money. So here are the gift leaks out of what we're going to get from Melon, Strawberry, and Grape gifts. That is appeared on screen right now. Over the course of all 21 days, the maximum times you'll be able to claim neighborhood points in the Melon rewards is 16, in Strawberry is 8, and then in Grape is 4. The cost is on there too, but note each time that the Melon, Strawberry, and Grape come out, you'll only be able to claim a max of 3 or 4 each time. So for the Melon, we can kind of expect it to be 4 separate days of the 21 where we'll get neighborhood points in, and then in Strawberry it might be 4 days again where it's a max of 2 times that you can claim it each time, and then on the Grape it'll come out on 4 different days and you can only claim a maximum of 1. The split might be completely random, so you've got to be careful on when you're planting your seeds in order to grow these. But if you manage to claim every single one of these, then you're getting yourself an extra 2,720 neighborhood points. Remember how earlier I was saying you need an extra 3,945 neighborhood tokens in order to get Messi? It means if you manage to claim all the gifts, then you need an extra 1,225 points, which in Resort is just 3 gem packs. So Messi, if you do the path every single day and you manage to get every single gift, Messi is just 7,500 gems. And then 10,000 gems if you want to get the icon Riquelme. This in short is actually a really good event, and I actually might try and get this Messi. On screen right now is the rotation of the egg hunt players. So currently there is a 98 Brandt out, but I'll leave this on screen for you right now to end up seeing where you can screenshot it. There's also a missing Kevin De Bruyne, 101 rated, and a 99 Klosterman. They are in chain packs, which will probably come in week 2 or week 3 of the event. And there's also two missing event icons. So as you can see, the Riquelme was in the event, but there's a missing David Suker and Raul. I'm expecting these to come out on the third week of the event. So we're currently in week one. I reckon in 7 days, we'll end up getting the chain packs. And then 7 days after getting the chain packs, then we'll get these event icons. It might be the other way around. We might end up getting the event icons first, and then the week after, we might get the chain packs, which will include this Klosterman and De Bruyne. But note, some of these players as well do have extra skill moves. So this 100 rated Messi has the Ronaldo chop as his secondary skill move. And this 98 Brandt has the lane change role skill move. This is only available on goalkeepers usually. So putting that on an outfield player is a little bit interesting, but might be a good card nonetheless. But yeah, this event is pretty good. If you are predominantly free to play, you're not going to spend any gems. You can claim yourself either of the Bentner brothers. You can claim yourself both 99. As well as a choice of either of the 95 overall players. If you want to get the Messi, he's 20k gems unless you get some extra points out of the gifts. You're going to be smart on how many gifts that you claim. Matchup melons need 8 hours after planting them in order to grow. The strawberries need 12 hours. And then the goalpost grapes need 24 hours. And you can only unlock them after you got 100 sunshine points. You get the 20 at the start. You get an extra 30 on node 5. And then you get the 100 on node 8. So it's not until node 8 until you can end up planting the grapes. So in short, there's a lot of resources on offer. It's up to you what you do with your gifts. But I think in terms of the play rewards, and a 96 end of era, a 95, and both 99s is really good value for me. I'm not too keen on the structure, but I know some of you guys out there would like it. If this guy did end up helping you out, please do leave a like and subscribe. But that's it from me here today. Remember, all my socials are in the top of the description. I appreciate all the support. And until the next video, I will catch you guys a little bit later. Stay sick, stay epic, and peace. Out. Adios.